What's going on, everybody? This is Grumpy Monkey Plays, and today we're playing some Car Mechanic Simulator. Yeah, I mean, I want to post it, see how it does. I don't really have high expectations of how it does. Alright, we're at the junkyard, and let's see what we can find. Another Challenger. We got a Hellcat. The generics. I guess we're doing the Challenger. How much they want for it first? $12 million. All right. Okay, we can do that. All right. I'll see you at the garage. Alright, my plan is to get all the parts I need to build the car, and then y'all can watch me build it. I mean, I hope y'all like that. I mean, be nice, but let's get into tearing this car apart. Probably chop all this out because I'm gonna bore y'all with all the building and whatnot. See, I got another project here too. I think this is a Maserati. Yeah, it's a Maserati. I just picked it up from the junkyard a couple days ago in here. And yeah. I don't really know much about cars, but I know enough. Like, basic stuff. And I always do this. Every time I'm fixing a car, whether it's off camera or on camera, I always pull out like the radiator, like anything that I can attempt to repair on the repair bench, I'll pull it out first. And then if I can repair it, I can repair it. Just like none of that stuff I just pulled out is not repairable. But hopefully y'all like this video. I mean, I see that you guys really love, well, not love, I'll say that, but y'all like my Call of Duty series, or not series, but close enough, but like the video I posted yesterday, which you probably won't see this until, what is today's date? Today is Thursday. You probably won't see this until Friday, which that's the way I do it. Like, I try to space out my videos now, so it's not like all kind of videos, like 5 videos a week, because whenever I was doing that before, some of the videos would get like decent views and some of them wouldn't. And I appreciate the ones that watch it. There is some that watch it and that's not subscribed. But, I can't make you subscribe if you don't want to. But, yeah. I'll do, like, 3 videos a week until, like, I don't know. I don't even know what I'm trying to say. Yeah, but, I'll do 3 videos a week and go from there. Usually, I work on the motor first. Sometimes, I work on the frame itself. Like, all the underneath parts, suspension-wise. But I don't know how I want to do it today. I don't want to put no Ford Blue motor in it. It's a Dodge, so. Let's see. I'll put a supercharger in this thing. Like how, Vin Diesel's was in Fast and the Furious. I'll put that in there. V8 two carb. Yeah. And here it is. I think, yeah. Looks about right. Well, let's get into it. I mean, I don't want to sit here and... Oh, and something else too. Like, I love to put, like the power boost parts in there. Like, I love doing that. And, it's just... It makes the car a whole lot faster, which I'm pretty sure you guys know that. But, yeah. It makes the car a hell of a lot faster. And, and it also sells for more, too. If I'm gonna be honest with you. But. I mainly know the basic stuff to get for it. Until it goes to building it, then I'll have to, search it up. And I don't want to bore you guys with a long video, so I'll chop most of it out in editing. So, you know, it won't be that long. Some people might enjoy it, some people might not. I mean, it just depends on, like, if you like watching longer videos or not. But if you guys stick through and watch the whole thing, hey, thank you guys for that. Because this is my, like, passion. I love doing YouTube. What the heck? Oh, no, I didn't buy the fuel filter. But, anyways, like I was saying, like, this is a passion of mine. Like, YouTube is amazing. Like, there's no telling how many people's told me that I can't do what I'm doing. And, yeah, I've listened to them, but... I don't listen to them anymore. This is what I want to do. And I'm not going to let nobody stop me from doing what I want to do. Alright, let's see here. Got my alternator. Power steering pump. Oh, now I just need a crankshaft, camshaft, and a oil filter. I think I can get the camshafts. From here. Yeah. Wait, what's this thing? Sometimes it's a regular camshaft, sometimes it's V8 overhead valve. And that's the only thing, like, it gets me confused. Like, if it wasn't like that, I could have these motors built in no time. But, and also where I just recently woke up to, so I'm not all there right now. It's like, I'm like half and half. There we go. Half awake, half asleep type deal. Like, what am I doing? See, told you. Let's see here. I need that. Let's see here. Water pump. Where's my timing cover? And then I need the timing chain. So it should have most of the front end put together now. Nope. I forgot my cam gear. I think. Yeah, I forgot my cam gear. Dang it. How could you guys let me forget that? Come on now. I'm just playing with you guys. But yeah. If the video's too long, I'll chop it down some. Because I don't want to, like, have an hour long video or something. And, you know, and on that City Skylines video I posted, I think it was like 2 weeks ago or something like that, but I said I was going to chomp out most of the parts while I was quiet, and I watched it, like, back in recording, and come to find out, I didn't take out any part where I stopped talking at. I need the water pump pulley. I think it's just a regular water pump pulley too. They never really let me, yeah, it's just a regular pulley. But yeah, this time I promise you, if it's a quiet, I will, or no, I need the supercharged water pump pulley. No, I don't know, whichever one works. But the only thing I hate about these motors, and I will definitely edit it out, because I don't know, I do not want you guys seeing me struggle with the valve push rods. Like, those are a pain in the neck. Because, like, they're so tiny. And I try to use a mouse. But, see, I'm moving the mouse now and it won't let me use it on here. Which, I guess I kind of understand that because it was ported over, you know, from a PC to a console. But, no, like I said, I understand all that. But yeah, that kind of has the whole top put together. So now, I will turn the motor. Oh man, I keep forgetting all the important stuff. Hang on, I need the caps. Oh, I think the caps. I don't know, I'm not going to wait. Y'all smarter than me when it comes to this, I guarantee it. Alright, there's those. And here's that. There's that. And there. Alright, and now we just go to the tedious part of it. And that's doing all this one by one. Wait, piss. Those. You don't put the oil pan on. You won't have any oil. And then your motor will blow up. I'm just going to put the flywheel on, the clutch pressure plate, and the clutch plate, and the bearing cap, the release bearing cap. I think that's what it's called. No, the release. Release bearing. There we go. Back in English properly. Now let's see here. No, I always do that. Okay, let's see. Engine head. That's something else I love about these, like, aftermarket parts, is you can just see how, like, chrome they are, and, man, it's so pretty. Like, just look at it. Just watch. Watch this thing. Man. And I'm not gonna keep the Challenger because if I could show you my garage, like, or the parking lot, what it's called. Like, I have a Challenger and a Charger in there, because, like, those are my two favorite old school cars. And, yeah, I love those cars. Yeah, I think I have a Roadrunner in there, too. I think, no. I'm not 100% sure, but pretty sure I have a Roadrunner in there. Along with, I have two Porsches. I have the, no, three Porsches. I have the 911 Turbo and the 911 America, I think. I'll show you all the cars once I get this done. I can only pull out three at a time, and I'll do that toward the end of the video. So, like, if you watched it this far, just, you can watch it until the end, and, I mean, I think you guys will like them. I mean, I don't know, like, because I try to make vehicles look as stock as possible on the outside, like how I would do in real life. And, some of the cars just, I souped them up, except for, the Porsche America, I think, I don't know for sure, but I'm pretty sure I souped that up. And there's something else too, I don't know, but like I said, these things, I don't think I got 16 of them. No, I don't think I did. See what I'm saying? Like, I'm gonna chop this out, so I'm gonna just stop talking, just so I'll be able to know when to chop it out. Alright, guys, well, I got the pain in the neck out of the way, so now we're putting these on. I went ahead and bought these while I was getting the rocker caps, and I was like, might as well just go and buy this while I'm thinking about it, so I wouldn't have to go back and get it later, like, toward the end, like, after I got finished with it, that's what I'm trying to say. And I wish I can get a supercharger. Like, on the, this is a power, whatever it's called. I don't know what the heck it's called. I don't look at it to think power boost. I wish I can get a supercharger on here, but I can't. Oh well. You know what they're saying? Because I don't. But yeah. I don't see anything else I can get. But let's see. I need the supercharger manifold. Supercharger itself. Supercharger serpentine belt. I just looked over. And that, and I think, no, I'm not done yet. I have to get the scoop and the scoop, thingies, whatever they're called. But I can get a carburetor for this. I think. And then, yep. See, this is why I bought the serpentine belts ahead of time. But, I got to buy the radiator fan. That's great. Look at Grumpy Monkey go. He gets the radiator fan. Yeah. Don't call me to be your mechanic, because I don't forget all kinds of stuff. But, all jokes aside, though, I am trying to learn how to work on vehicles. Like, for, like, a real-life situation. And, I'm not the best at working on vehicles. I ain't gonna lie to you. I mean, I've always been a gamer, so... I don't know, it's just a passion, like, and it will always be a passion, to be honest with you, but yeah, but I don't know what to do about the suspension, because I don't want you guys, like, I don't want you guys to have to sit in here and, like, have to watch the whole freaking thing, you know, because, like, that would make me a bad YouTuber if I sit here and made you watch the whole thing. But the motor is complete. Now we'll work on this. Gosh, what is somewhere? It's been recording for 21 minutes. I do want to try to get these rims. And what I might try to do is I might try to fix them and but let's see. Oh, I know what I'm gonna do, alright? I'm gonna stop my recording, and then I'm gonna start recording back once I have all the parts needed, so I can finish this up. All right. So I promise you guys, I will. I'll start recording. All right. And after about 30, 40 minutes. I mean, I think 30, 40 minutes. Who knows? But anyways, I got it all tore down. See, it's empty. Let's see how much this thing values for just a frame. $8,000. Let's see if we can change it. Alright. Oh, and if you guys want to see more of this, let me know. And the ones that do want to see more of it, tell me a color to put the car, like, for an example, if y'all want to see it green, let me know in the comment section, because then I can make my subscribers, like, I can have their favorite color on a car, if that makes sense to y'all. I mean, I think the idea is pretty cool, and, like I said, if you want to see that, or, if you want to see more, just let me know in the comment section, and I will make it happen. It ain't no trying to it. I will make it happen. You can also give me suggestions on what cars to get, because I only have like a few DLCs. Like, it's the Dodge, the Maserati pack, and something else. I don't know 110%, but it's some DLCs, you know, just let me know. If you want to, you can look up the DLCs. And, there's a certain car you want to see me to do next, I can try to find it. And if I can't, I can always go to the car salon, buy it, tear it down, and, remake it. But, I mean, I don't really know for sure, but look at the rims. Some nice chromed out rims. Heck yeah. Especially for a car like this, you know, it needs the glory of having You know, nice chrome rims. I mean, I don't know. I feel like that's the way old cars should be. Like, they should have some, like, nice. I don't know what the brand name's called. I don't even want to try to act like I know it, but it's the ones that you see with all these like old muscle cars, like the old 69 Camaros and stuff, like that. They should have like weird rims like that. Well, not the exact kind, but like similar design or whatever it's called. But yeah, that's what I feel like it should be. But who knows, honestly. I mean, I'm just some crazy guy trying to do YouTube videos. I mean, hopefully I don't think I'm crazy, but sometimes I think I'm crazy. Nah, but all jokes aside, yeah, just let me know what y'all want to see, like vehicle-wise. And there's also some pretty nice, like generic, cars on here. That Playway put on here. I think it's Playway that made this game. Pretty sure it's Playway. But yeah, like they got some nice generic cars on here too, which I think are pretty cool. Look at these. Ooh, that looks so good. Like, look, it's got some beef. Some beef on there. Yeah, I bought a second fuel tank too, which I didn't think about until like a couple minutes ago before I started recording back. I could use the shit. See, this is what I hate about this. Like, yeah. Especially playing on controller. But anyways, like I was saying, I could use the other fuel tank for the. Do you see that blue car over there? And use the second fuel tank for that. So then I'll be able to, get that one fixed up too. But like I said, I tried to get all the parts I needed. I mean, hopefully I didn't miss one or two or something like that. But I have five of these U-bolts because I thought that I wasn't gonna be able to repair one of them, which that was the case. I couldn't fix one of them, but I bought two just in case. I had to buy an extra one. Like, I know I'm probably making a lick of sense, but I lose my train of thought too easy. But I bought a second one, or I bought the two ones, the two that I needed. I'm sorry if I'm jabbering everywhere, but I bought the two U-bolts that I needed. Come to find out, I repaired the other two. Like, that's never happened. I've always ended up having to buy two U-bolts. That's why I got a spare one, because I thought I was gonna need it for a previous build I did, and I didn't, because guess what? I replaced it. But I guarantee you, if I go over to fix the rear end on that Maserati, I'll buy one, and then I'll have to end up buying about two more. I have a feeling that's what's gonna happen, but who knows? I could be wrong, could be right. I don't know anymore. But yeah. I really hope you guys do enjoy this video like I do, because this game is it's a good game. Did I not get my other tire off the thing? Wow. I didn't even put it on there. Wait, did I? Hello? I didn't balance it? What? Wow. Well, that's a goof. I'm sorry, guys. I tried to overdo things, and that's what happens. Rule in life: don't overdo. Like, don't try to work too hard to get something done, because you always end up goofing. Look at me. I was setting this up perfectly. I was like, all my subscribers only get to see me do the simple things, and sure enough, I get to do. Get to putting it back together, and then what happens? What happens? I forget to do the tire, but hopefully I got the right gearbox too. Oh, and I already got the motor too, and already got all the body parts as well. So See, remember, it was 8,000 before, and then we're going to see what the price is after I get all the good stuff put on there, like the radiator, the battery. See, I stocked up on batteries because you can never have too many batteries. What? I forgot my brake servo. My brake servo, too. But, yeah. And... Alright. But this game... I like car mechanics anyway. I like it because it's a simple game. And like I said, whenever I was playing... What game was it that I was doing? It was... Hang on. Was it City Skylines? I think it was. Where I said, like, this is different than the other games I play. And the reason why is, like, you know, I just posted a Call of Duty video, but believe it or not, I recorded that video in, like, April? March or April? One of those 2 days? One of those 2 months? But, yeah. And see, that's what I was saying, like, a while back ago, back when I was playing Call of Duty constantly, is some of the videos that you watch a month, besides, the three I recently posted, like, those videos are... The videos that I've recorded, like, weeks, maybe months ago. Like, it's just because, like, I don't really get the feedback that I need. So, I don't know if you guys want to see that. So, I just got videos sitting on my YouTube Studio app that ain't, like, getting posted, you know? And, you know, I don't want to post them and then not get no views from them. And, yeah, it's just, I don't know, it's just like, you spend a lot of time recording a video, and then, all of a sudden, like, nobody watches it. So then you're like, well, I got five videos recorded, and they're not by my trunk. But anyways, yeah, like, I got five videos posted. And nobody's watched them. So you get, you know, you don't want to post that. That's why I didn't buy it. It's way down here. But, anyways, like I was saying, you don't want to post it because you're worried that nobody's going to watch it. Like, that's my thinking. Like, I had all these videos recorded, and, like, the very first Call of Duty video I posted, it went crazy. Like, I wasn't expecting that. It was like, wow. Like, that was my thought whenever I saw, like it had like 30 some odd views or something like that. I was like, man, this is crazy. And there was one I posted that got like 17 views or something like that. And I was like, man, all this work, only 17 people wanted to watch it. I mean, you know, I can't force y'all to watch my content, nor will I ever. Like, but at the same time, it's discouraging to a content creator like myself, because it makes me feel like nobody likes my content, and you know, it just makes me not want to record as much. I know, I'm sorry for rambling, but, you know, just, I don't know, I'm sorry, guys. I just, when I get to talking about a subject, I just want to make sure that everything comes out the way I want it to, and I don't want to try to sound like I'm putting the blame on somebody, but, no, should I go base color with it? I might just do that. Yeah, not my car anyways. If it was mine, it'd go black. Matte black. Like Dom's Charger. But did it go to the down? I don't know. See, that's another thing I hate about playing freaking controller. Is you have to hold this little arrow doodad where it needs to be at. But I, like I said, I'm sorry for rambling, but I just had to get that off of my, like, my chest, because I try to, you know, like, I want to stay positive in videos and whatnot, and sometimes it's hard to, because I feel like nobody likes my content, but to those who actually watch it, I appreciate y'all. I love y'all. I love all my subscribers. All 106 of y'all. Now, I try to stay humble too. Like, you know, I don't want to forget where I came from. From my first subscriber to my 106th one. But, anyways, stop getting sappy and soppy. But, let's see here. Holy crap. $82,000 plus a $16,000 restoration bonus. Heck yeah. Wait, hang on. But anyways, guys, it's been Grumpy Monkey. Like, comment, subscribe, share if you want to. I'm not going to make you do any of that. But if you want to see more videos like this, just let me know. The likes really help me. Like, I just wouldn't want to say that. If you like my, like my content and I see the likes, I'm like, all right, I'm going to do more of that. And just like with the Call of Duty Black Ops Cold War video I just posted, posted yesterday. I'm gonna post more of that. But anyways, guys, Grumpy Monkey, I love you guys. Peace.